Hello from WCPT Congress 2017 in Cape Town. I'm here with Jean-Sebastian Roy. He's Associate Professor in the Rehabilitation Department at Laval University in Quebec, Canada. And his symposium just now was concerned with the question why rotator cuff tendinopathies become chronic. Well, trials suggest that long-term outcome is poor in more than 30% of patients. Which factors are associated with chronification?
I think there are several factors that need to be considered when looking at the shoulder. One factor that we're looking at my research center is central reorganization, so brain reorganization following a shoulder pain. And I think that's one of the main reasons why people become chronic, and that the success rate is so low for rehabilitation of the shoulder. So I think we have to consider the not only the joint, but the brain that controls the joint and all the receptor that send information to the brain, and the messages that is sent by the brain to the joint. So I think that the main reason, but there's also other reason like sensorial sensitization that was just discussed during the symposia. I think also proprioception might be also one of the reasons that may explain this low rate of success.
And to what extent are central changes and central sensitization relevant in the process of chronification? You mentioned it, but can you explain it in more detail?
Central reorganization, if the brain doesn't control the joint as it supposed to, let's say that the infraspinatus is inhibited, then the how we move the shoulder will be perturbed. So usually it leads to a bad movement of the humeral head. So the humeral head is not centralized, and then it can lead to injury to the tendon, to the bursa. That's one thing that brain reorganization can lead to. As for central sensitization, the problem is that instead of having a normal signal of pain following the injuries, the signal is amplified by the brain. So instead of having a normal pain, just a small nociceptive signal would be amplified. So people will think that they have huge pain. And that can become problematic because they're getting scared. They have fear avoidance eventually. So it's a cascade. It's getting worse and worse. That's why you have to explain the pain phenomenon, explain the central changes, explain how the shoulder is controlled or should be controlled. And then I think it really helps people getting a sense of why they have pain and what they can do to decrease the level of pain.
And how could these deficits be addressed in physical therapy?
There's different ways. What we use in our research is a lot of sensory motor training. So we show them, we use feedback, we use mirror, we show them how they move their shoulder, how they should move. We help them correct the movement. So that's a way, sensory motor training. During sensory motor training, we also the aim is also to make sure that the patient can feel their shoulder and can correct by themselves their deficit. So that's a way. Education is key also. In fact, education should always be the first thing that we should use with these chronic patients. Education on motor control, education on pain, just to understand what is pain, how it works. I think it's very important for our patients. So that's the two main thing that we use. A lot of the education, a lot of sensory motor training, and we, that's the two main thing that we use, yeah.
Thank you very much. It was a great pleasure to talk to you. Thank you for your attention. Goodbye.